this question, but let me read it to you. I think as a city council, you know, we've, you know, we don't necessarily always agree upon issues. And at the end of the day, collaboration and mutual respect are cornerstones, frankly, on getting things done. And if you go back in the city's past, there's been certain times where maybe that hasn't existed. So what would you do to promote a collaborative and mutually respectful environment if you so buy into that concept?
Oh, of course I do. Well, I would go back to, I haven't been involved in communities where people are yelling at each other or if there's an air of disrespect. Maybe you all have. But we have always been very critical, like in a fighter pilot debrief. Everything is brought out. We have a closed door session and we all speak our minds, and that's the only way we can improve and get better. So first of all, we don't terminate discussion that may be a little bit uncomfortable. We allow that to continue, and we thoughtfully listen. And if there is an element of disrespect, or if there's an element of heatedness that needs to be quelled, we can always take a little break, go back, gather our thoughts, and maybe review some of the points and try to ferret out what the core issue is of disagreement, and then work through it in that way. You know, that's where sometimes the regulations don't always tell the whole story. We need to be able to exercise judgment, right? That's why there's a council. It's not a city regulatory agency, it's a city council. So we apply our judgment and draw upon many of our experiences that we've had in life and try to come up with creative solutions that would still contribute to the ultimate goal of the committee that we talked about earlier.
Thank you.
Sure.
You really did get things done in 30 days?
We absolutely 100% did.
Yeah, there's evidence of government.
It was no kidding. I mean, in fact, I would arrive on station and maybe only be, you know, 24 to 48 hours, I would be on station there and you'd only have 28 days left. The clock was ticking and you had to have a draft done within basically 14 days. And there was, like I said, there was a four-star general waiting, and they didn't push that in line. So it was stressful. It was a little bit stressful.
Thank you. Glenn?
Hi, nice to meet you earlier, too. So, as a city council member, you might be asked to represent the city at regional and state activities and meetings or ceremonies. How would you describe the image or the personification that you would project as a city representative from La Piana at these events? Like the persona of the city?
What is my characterization of the city, yeah, you're suggesting? You know, this from when we first started this discussion, the volunteerism and the desire to serve, I think that's part of the fabric of this city. And I think I would represent that well. You know, I have a track record of service, and it's about being humble, and it's about listening. As far as the committees go that you're discussing and the type of characterization of La Piñata, this is a wonderful family-oriented community with a nice little small pocket of some businesses that are here in the town center, and we all enjoy that. This is, I don't want to call this Mayberry because it's not, because we're a growing city. We're a little more forward-thinking than that, and I would like to think that I could reflect that forward-thinking. Our demographics are in fact changing a little bit in this area, in this localized area here. My mother is actually a Japanese immigrant. I'm a second-generation Asian American. Both of our, my wife is actually from Taiwan, but she grew up here in Iowa, of all places. We have three beautiful boys. Jackson, he's going to be starting in ninth grade this coming year. He's active in the scouting community. He's you know, doing water polo. My little son, middle son, MacArthur, he's going to be in sixth grade at PCY. All of our kids have gone through, or are going through, the public school system. And our littlest boy, he's 3.5 years old, Wyatt, he'll probably be going to LC because that's where our residence dictates it now. So they're all fluent in Mandarin, age appropriate. Our littlest is becoming conversant in Francais. So it's nice, and I think that represents very well the demographic of those that are in La Piñata and how it's changing. So I think combining my leadership experiences as well as my personal life experiences along with tying them in with the family values, I think is in and of itself very representative of what Wakandot is, forward-thinking, a good home community, and a little bit affluent sometimes, right?
So, sure. That's great. Thank you. Thanks for your service to the Air Force.
Oh, and
my coming out here on, I guess, Monday, hot mm-hmm. Monday, to talk with someone. I appreciate it. I went to PCY, by the way, so it's
yes.
All right. It was a long time ago.
A little different school.
Different
back
school?
Then. Yeah.
School hasn't been the same since.
It had, yeah. It's
just trying.
I know. All right. Like it.
So, John, thank you very much. We appreciate everything you've done and everything you do in the community. And thank you for doing this process. So, what we're doing tonight is we're going through and interviewing some of the many people, and then we'll interview more people tomorrow morning. We're scheduled to session tomorrow night at 5 o'clock,
okay.
And the council will